In an incredible case study demonstrating audience capture, Newsmax ended up deleting an X post that they had put up criticizing one of Trump's statements, which led to absolute fury from the MAGA right. So the backlash sparked panic at the right-wing cable network, and eventually they did decide to delete the tweet. But what did it say? So the post linked to a Newsmax page that housed a Reuters wire service story. That means it was written by Reuters and Newsmax licensed it and just reprinted it or reposted it on their website. It was a story on Trump's latest comments about undocumented immigrants and crime. The Newsmax story is titled, "Trump calls migrants animals in Michigan, stop." So this was during one of his rally speeches. It points out that according to studies, people living in the United States illegally do not commit violent crimes at a higher rate than native-born citizens. And we've talked about studies like that. That data is out there, it's absolutely true, but it's not the kind of data that people necessarily want to see on Newsmax's website or as a post on X. So the post on X also used the caption that was worded by Reuters and read, "Donald Trump called immigrants in the United States illegally animals and not human in a speech in Michigan, resorting to the degrading rhetoric he has employed time and again on the campaign trail." So we actually talked about those comments on the show, and what he was specifically referring to were criminals like the individual who killed, it was an undocumented immigrant who ended up killing allegedly a college student in Georgia. And so he was talking about that, and while talking about that, he referred to people like that criminal as an animal, not human. And so Newsmax, I don't know who made the decision to post it on X, but I remember seeing it when they did so, and I was shocked that they posted it. The comments, the responses, the mentions for Newsmax after they posted that were insane. People were really, really furious about it. So they did eventually end up taking it down. So a Newsmax producer who asked to remain anonymous told Mediaite, at the New York offices of the cable channel where the social media team is located, they are scrambling trying to figure out who approved that post. It's especially sensitive because the common belief on the inside, of Newsmax, of their studios, is that, you know, they do everything for Trump. They cater to Trump. And then the producer said, MAGA is furious. So I don't know if that means someone within the Trump camp spoke to someone over at Newsmax, but Newsmax anchor Bob Schmidt posted a now deleted post saying, "We had a low-level social media staffer mindlessly post a headline and story straight from AP. It's been addressed." So I mean, look, maybe Newsmax genuinely doesn't agree with that post, and maybe it was a low-level staffer who did it. But I think if you delete things because you're getting fury from your audience, especially if you actually believe in what you've posted, it just demonstrates audience capture. And are you really doing your audience a favor by simply feeding them what they want to hear? I mean, what's the point? You're nothing more than a propagandist that's giving the masses exactly what they want. That's not news.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you. Thank you. Okay, let's keep it real here. Most of news media is just marketing. It's just whoever you want to market for. Right-wing media markets for Republicans and Trump. Mainstream media markets for the establishment, establishment Democrats and establishment Republicans. None of them are fair. None of them are objective, not even close. And they all cater to their own audience. And New York Times, who do they cater to? Top 10%, because that's the people who read the New York Times, generally speaking. So they frame everything from the perspective of someone who is in the elites, the establishment, the wealthy, the well-educated, etc. So I'm not at all surprised that Newsmax is doing it. Is it funny? Of course it's funny, right? You put out an article by Reuters that is factually correct. But I have one important caveat here. But you put out one that's factually correct and your audience flips out And you're like, we're so sorry. We're so sorry. We didn't mean to give you actual truth. We slipped for a second and thought we were a news organization. No, here's validation candy. Trump is great. Trump here, you know, like a little pacifier. And then the audience goes back to, this is what I like. This is what I like. So, for example, the thing about that Anna already mentioned about how natural born citizens commit crime at a much greater rate than undocumented immigrants. That's a stone cold fact, right? We don't like that fact. Give us back the pacifier, okay? But now, to be fair, there is another side here. Look, on the animal thing, I watched a lot of Trump speeches, and this is not a scientific study. I'm not quoting a polling or research on this, but my sense of watching this Trump speeches is when he talks about undocumented immigrants, does he say the word animal in regards to criminals? About 2/3 of the time. The 1/3 of the time, he says it about all undocumented immigrants, and sometimes about all immigrants, period. Is he just screwing up because he has verbal diarrhea, or does he actually mean it about all immigrants and he has giving himself the plausible deniability of saying, I largely meant it about the criminals? Who knows? Probably both, right? So if you're a conservative and you're upset at the framing of a title that makes it seem like he's saying it every time about all undocumented immigrants, I can see getting upset about that. And I can
see, for sure.
Yeah. And so that's why this one is not as clear-cut case. But you know, if you're a right winger out there and you come on, at least try to look into the facts so you know what the right thing to complain about is. If you say Donald Trump has never said animals in regard to immigrants when he wasn't referring to criminals, you're just wrong, right? So at a bare minimum, he should be a lot more careful about that. But to me, what he's doing is he's demagoguing and he's trying to get his side to hate immigrants, mainly Latinos, some now, you know, during COVID, Asians, etc. And so you should ask better of your news organizations than to just give you the pacifier candy that you want.
The thing is, you're going to attract the audience that you deserve. That's the way I feel about it, right? So if you're specifically pandering to a specific audience, well, then you are now in an ideological prison where you have to constantly cater to that audience. And so I don't know. I just feel like what's the point of pursuing media or journalism? I mean, Newsmax journalism, that's hilarious. But like, what's the point if all you are is someone who comes on air for an hour or two a day and you just give people, you know, the, you know, sedation that they so desperately want? It's ridiculous. You build the audience that you deserve. And if you are willing to tell the truth and have takes or analysis that people might not expect, I think that you're gonna draw in an audience of people who are intellectually curious, who want to engage in debates and conversations in good faith. It's just that it's really, really hard to build that. And it's not the most profitable, like it's not a quick scheme for profitability. Pandering is a quick scheme for profitability. And I think that's part of the reason why you're seeing it as a typical model in media these days, Cenk.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, you guys have seen it with your own eyes. Number one, in every story, we're fair and we tell you not both sides, reality. I don't care what the Republicans want or Trump wants or what the Democrats and Biden want. I don't care what they want. I care about the truth and reality. And like a good example is the distinction we just made about animals. You've also seen us defy our own audience. I use many examples, including when I started criticizing Obama. We lost a lot of members back then. We've lost members and viewers at different times because we wouldn't do what everyone else does, which is just, okay, we've got an audience in some part of the political spectrum and they just give them whatever they want, whether it's true or not. No, I know, we're nuts. We're actually in the news business and care about what's true. So if you want that, you can come to the Young Turks. If you want pacifiers, there's news organizations that are handing out pacifiers all around us, almost everyone else. Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.